guys, Ralph here, and welcome to True Power Trumpet Fitness on this terrific, terrific Tuesday here in Connecticut. Anyway, you saw the thumbnail. Vlado revisited, man. I tell you what, the world loves this guy. My comments, my emails blew up, as well as the views. Guys, wonderful. Thank you. I told you right at the beginning, I knew very, very little about him, and we got some very, very cool stuff about it. Very, very cool stuff. Okay? Anyway, I've not played. Let me honk, see what we got. How's that for a warm-up? You eating and drinking your fruits and vegetables? Speaking of which, I am doing a video on my other channel, True Power Weight Loss Center. Google it, on specifically lemonade. My lemonade recipe. And I'll tell you what, I've had so many great comments from clients about it. Guys, if you do nothing, don't work out anymore, don't eat the same, don't have to go vegan. If you drink the lemonade, you will lose weight. Anyway, for another channel. Now, Vlado, my man, geez. The views blew up, the comments blew up, the emails, forget about it. The world loves Vlado Kumpen. Am I pronouncing it right? It doesn't matter, does it? But I'll tell you what, I asked very much an impassioned plea, please give me some comments. Tell me more about him if you know anything about him. Okay? And a lot of you did. We had a lot. I didn't know we had that many people in Europe that were viewing, you know, the language barrier and all this sort of stuff. But Germany and whatnot like that, they do know some English. So anyway, thank you so much for that. That was wonderful. With that said, there was a couple things. First of all, I asked, does anybody know what mouthpiece he uses? It certainly looked like a Bach mouthpiece. Now, there was one comment from a viewer. It's still there if you want to go back and watch it. Pretty sure it was an old 3C Bach. Okay? Now, that explains a lot. That explains a lot. The older Bach mouthpieces are a completely different animal than whatnot than they are now. Completely different animal, okay? The Mount Vernon Bachs are a completely different animal. Different tools, different bag, but a completely different animal. And explains a lot, okay? Now, I went to my man JJ. JJ, for some reason, your comment on the mouthpiece got deleted. So if you want to do that again, please do for the benefit of the... for the greater good. But now, it was interesting because there was a guy at Manus my first year. He was a senior and I was a freshman, and he was the best. He was the best player in the school. Tremendous, tremendous all-around player. Wanted to get into Broadway and did get into Broadway, all that sort of thing, but could still play tremendous. He had great chops. Vacchiano, of all people, loved him, and he played a Mount Vernon 3C, okay? Vacchiano loved it. Vacchiano offered him so much money to give him that mouthpiece, and he wouldn't do it. He wouldn't do it. Vacchiano started off at $5 and got up to 50, and then he stopped. He just said, Mr. Vacchiano, thanks, but... Anyway, I pleaded with this guy. I pleaded with, because I had never played in Mount Vernon before. I pleaded with this guy. Let me know. Now, he's very, very germ phobic. And I said, please, we'll get this antiseptic. I'll go down to Giardinelli's and get all this. So I said, please just let me honk a few notes. And I'm telling you what, man, I had a 3C of my own at the time. Not the same thing. I know it was a different back bore, and it was the equivalent to my way of thinking of a 3E. Okay? A 3E. Now, I'm not going to try to make excuses because somebody can actually play a Bach mouthpiece, but all bets are off on the Mount Vernon. Okay? And I told you, I got pretty good results on a Bach 10.5C, the conventional one. So it can be done. Mel Broyles and John, it can be done. But to that degree, I'm very, very surprised it was a Bach mouthpiece. But if it was a Mount Vernon, explains a lot. Okay? Now, I am going to do a video tomorrow on a guy named Eric Parks. Okay? Now, anybody that has played in the New York area knows the name if they've never played with him. Okay? The minute I heard Ice Castles, okay, I just immediately thought of Eric Parks because he was lead trumpet for a long time with the Jimmy Sturr Band, and he definitely has an extraordinary version of Ice Castles, okay? And he is definitely using Jerry's equipment, mouthpiece, trumpet, whatever, okay? Took some lessons with Jerry, one of Jerry's guys. Anyway, we'll save that for tomorrow, okay? Because we're getting off the topic. But you'll be able to hear the difference in the tone. And the little bit of discrepancy that I heard in Vlado's tone, you'll be able to hear exactly what I'm talking about when you hear them side by side. Okay? So anyway, back to Vlado. 3C, an old 3C. Okay? Now, I wasn't sure if he was a legitimate double C guy. Okay? He absolutely is. He absolutely is. Another European guy came with a link that I will put down below that you wait to the end. If you want to skip right to the end, there's no question he ends on a double C. Okay? No questions and ends on a double C. And it's a good one. It's a good one. So, Bach mouthpiece, double C. Don't I look like I have egg on my face, right? Okay? And I'll tell you what, everybody talks to me whenever I slam Bach mouthpieces. Everybody says, well, Sandoval. Guys, his tone is so much cleaner, so much purer than Sandoval's. And again, Sandoval jazz, not even close. Not even close. You hear Vlado noodle around a little bit, and it's not in the same stratosphere. And Sandoval, his piano playing, genius. But it's not quite the same. It's not quite, and again, I'm getting off the subject. Chops. I get excited. Okay? So he does play double Cs. Okay? He does play a Bach mouthpiece. And he's a bit of a star. There's also one that somebody sent me with the Manzor brass that he's playing along with him, and he ends on a high B flat or something, double C, whatever the case may be. Guys, he's serious. He's serious. But again, any more thoughts about him, because the lines are burning up, let me know. But I want you to watch tomorrow. Want you to watch tomorrow. And I'm going to do something specifically on Eric Parks, and you'll see what I'm talking about. Okay, you'll absolutely see what I'm talking about. Now, I'm going to leave this off. Jerry loved Eric Parks' chops. Loved him, and I'll talk about this tomorrow. And Jerry didn't suffer fools gladly. He didn't slam people in public. He did not that he didn't like the chops, but he very, very picky about whose chops he liked and who did. Ray Rosario was another one. Mine towards, you know, the last 5, 8, 10 years he was comfortable with. But Eric Park, he raved about this guy. So you'll know exactly what I'm talking about. You'll know what I heard in my ear when I thought not a great mouthpiece is when you compare the two. But the guy can play. The guy can play. So from Slovakia with love, Vlado, you're the man. Anyway. Eat and drink your fruits and vegetables. You want to lose some weight? It'll be up this afternoon. It'll be up this afternoon if you want to go get it. Okay, guys. Love you all. And we'll talk tomorrow about Eric Parks.